Welcome back to my channel. Welcome to my home. I'm Eileen, and tonight I wanted to talk about a couple things. Of course, I want to talk about this week, but I had a couple more things I kind of want to discuss with you tonight. One being, you know, I'm thinking about changing things up a little bit. I love a first impressions of a wig. I like it right out of the box. I like to put it on. I want to see how I like it. I want to tell you how I like it. But, you know, honestly, to get a feel for a wig, you have to wear it for a while to decide exactly what do you like about it, what do you not like about it, you know, everything. You don't know that right out of the box on a first impression. So I think going forward, after I do my first impressions, I'm going to go wear it a couple weeks, few weeks, see how I like it, make some notes on it, what I like and what I don't like, and then I'm going to come back and I'm going to revisit it. And then at that time, I'll give you an update about how it wore, how it felt, what are, you know, the things I like, what are the things I don't like. So I think I'm going to change it up a little bit going forward and do things like that. It's a gloomy, gloomy day here. So I'm using my ring light, so if it gets a little glaring when I get up close, forgive me. I'm doing the best I can with that. Also, I want you to know, I buy all my own wigs. So please know that this, my channel, I'm not trying to sell you anything. I'm not trying to promote anything. These are my wigs that I've bought and that I wear. So that's why you always see blonde wigs from me, because I just don't have the funds to buy every color wig and review it. So most all wigs you're going to see from me are going to be some kind of blonde. But that's just the way it is for me. In talking about recording on my iPad, sometimes I might not look like I'm looking right at you, but if you're familiar with an iPad, you know the camera, the lens is on one side, and I am looking into the viewfinder here in the iPad, trying to make sure that my hair is good, that I'm showing you everything about it, pointing out the colors, pointing out the highlights. And so if it looks like I'm not looking directly at you, it's because I am looking into the iPad, but I am talking directly to you. I always want you to know, I want to talk to you, I want to connect with you. That's why I'm here. So that all being said, let's talk about this wig. This is Cori by Noriko. Now, I have Cori, and you'll be surprised at the color. Creamy toffee rooted. Big shock, right? If you've watched any of my videos with Noriko wigs, probably is being creamy toffee rooted. That's my color. That's what I'm comfortable with. So, and again, like I said, I buy these wigs, so I'm going to buy the color that I'm comfortable with. So Noriko, I love creamy toffee rooted. And either or something pretty close to it, so I won't vary too far off of that. But Cori was my very first wig, so I wanted to kind of talk about it. I thought it might be fun just to kind of talk about my first wig and how that all came to be. You know, when I realized that I was going to need a wig and I was going to need it pretty quickly, I number one was scared to death. I did not know where to begin, what to do, what was I going to do, how was I going to make this work. It was a scary time, and I think it is for a lot of women, you know, especially if you're dealing with health issues, you've got that whole thing going on, and then on top of that, I got to find a wig. How do I do that? So I watched a ton of YouTube videos in the beginning, just overloaded on that, and then I went to Dallas. And at Dallas, I went to Mimi's Wig Boutique. And I met the most wonderful women there. They were fantastic. Oh my gosh. I went while I still had hair, bio hair, and they matched it to my color and to my style as much as they could. And this was the closest that they got to it. Now, my bio hair was not this good, not this thick in any way. But that was just the way my bio hair was. And it's back now and it's just exactly the same. It's no better. So, but this was as close as they could get to it. And I really have enjoyed this. I have had three of these wigs. And the first year, I'd say, I pretty much basically wore this. But of course, as time has moved on and I've branched out and discovered lace fronts and monofilament tops and all that wonderful stuff, you know, but in the beginning, I didn't know what anything was. I just know I needed some hair and I needed it fast. And they provided that for me in a really wonderful, wonderful environment there. I can't say enough about those ladies. So Cori, she is a stack bob. She is just as basic as you can get. And y'all see my little dog back there. That's Minerva. She loves to get in the picture. So you'll probably see her a lot. But back to Corey, she's just a bob. She is just a basic as you can get bob. Let me show it to you. I like these face framing layers. Come in around the back. Lots and lots of movement in the back. And look at the nape. That's a good nape. A short nape. Can wear it with a collar. Never worry about it rubbing or bothering you in any way. Now, Corey has very textured bangs. And Corey has lots of permatease. If you are not a fan of permatease, you do not get this wig, because it's got plenty of it. And in the beginning, I had no clue what permatease was, but I'm from the South and I knew I liked big hair, so it was great, it's perfect for me. But if you don't like it, you won't like this wig, that's for sure, because there is plenty of it in there. But these layers around the face, I think, are flattering to most people. You can really get it going forward, or wear it behind your ears, anything like that. I wear it behind my ears a lot. I like it that way. I like things off my face, and so this has been perfect for that. But looking at this color, creamy toffee rooted. Like I said, I'm using my ring light, so I know it's bright. But I have another one, so I can show you up close. And, you know, we've talked about creamy toffee rooted on my channel many a times with the base of the light golden brown, medium golden blonde with the platinum highlights. And I love the platinum highlights in this one. Really pretty, and with the dark rooting. Again, lots of permatease here. If you don't like that and that bothers you in the part there, you're not going to like this, because it definitely has lots of permatease right there. Now let's look at the cap. It doesn't get much more basic than this. Basic open cap construction, permatease behind the lace, and that's a lot of it. No lace front, has a little felt right here. Open cap, ear tabs, not big ear tabs, but they do have stays. No extended nape, little bra strap adjusters. Very basic. And not a huge amount of stretch here either. Not a lot of stretch, okay? So that's a look at the cap construction. But again, it is a beautiful color. It holds its shape so well. It really does. Like I said, I've had three. I know all about this wig. I have worn them and worn them and worn them. And they have lasted me a long time. To me, this is a good first wig. You know, you don't have to spend a ton of money on a first wig. In my opinion, only my opinion, I think that it's good to start basic with a wig. See what you like. See how you get used to wearing a wig. It's hard just to get used to something on your head and getting used to wearing it. You have all the time in the world to branch out into lace fronts and monofilament tops and all that. But if you want to start basic, smart, start smaller, in my opinion, this is a good first wig. It certainly served me well, that's for sure. So let's do a little styling on Corey. Thank you. okay guys, that's my review of Corey. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoyed seeing my very first wig. I'd like to know, what was your very first wig? Leave me a comment below. And like I said, I'm going to change things up here a little bit, and we'll be revisiting some wigs that I've already reviewed, my first impressions, and I'm going to go back and do a little update for you on those. And I hope you'll subscribe to my channel, and I'll look forward to seeing you next time. And don't forget, we're all in this together.